Most printed circuit boards are made of woven fiberglass material, like this FR4. But lately, we're seeing a huge growth in the use of metal-clad boards, partly driven by the growth in LED lighting applications. So why metal-clad boards? Electronic components generate heat, and you need to dissipate that heat away from the component to avoid accelerated failure. But FR4 does not conduct heat very well. For smaller components, a sea of vias, or a thermal land pad, can be sufficient to dissipate the heat. But for larger LEDs and other high-power parts, you typically need to do more, like add an external heatsink. But heatsinks add bulk, and mounting them is labor-intensive and expensive. Metal-clad boards are a great alternative. They are cheaper and more effective than external heatsinks. With a base layer of aluminum, or sometimes copper, the board itself serves as one big heatsink. Then we have a very thin dielectric layer made of the same materials as regular PCBs. And then the circuit layer of copper and the solder mask. For LED boards, this is often white for greater reflectivity, but it can be green or many other colors. And now, bendable metal-clad boards let you bend the board to fit into small housings. These boards have a flexible polyimide for the dielectric layer instead of rigid FR4. Using metal-clad boards requires some changes in design, procurement, and manufacturing. In design, you will almost always want to stick with a single-sided layout on metal-clad boards. You have to factor the large ground plane into any RF analysis. And without the through-hole component, you'll need to think about using card edge connectors or wires for off-board connections. In procurement, you may have to evaluate new vendors. Fabricating metal-clad boards is more difficult, and not all vendors have the same level of experience with it. In manufacturing, you will have to adjust some of your processes. For example, depanelizing takes different equipment with higher force than you may need for fiberglass boards. Also, the reflow profile is completely different. It takes a lot of energy to heat the metal to 500 degrees Fahrenheit. You need to understand the thermal profile of each board and make sure that it reaches the proper temperature and holds it for the right amount of time for soldering. With the right design and manufacturing expertise, metal-clad boards are a great solution for creating small, reliable systems that incorporate high-power components, such as LED lighting systems and power supplies. Contact us if you'd like to learn more about using metal-clad boards.